The stars have arrived in Columbus. The captain of the Anaheim Ducks, Ryan Getzlaf, and his family. The captain in Tampa, Steven Stamkos, taking photographs with the fans in Columbus. The leading goal scorer for the LA Kings, Anze Kopitar, and his family getting their way to the convention center. And Jake Voracek, as the stars have aligned in Columbus. The All-Stars have arrived in Columbus, Ohio.
Pulls in, feet, and scores! What a play by Steven Stamkos!
He scores! Patrick Kane scores! Kessel slaps it home!
But the teams have yet to be picked. It will be up to these two captains to separate the group.
It's the captain, Jonathan Tane! Scores!
Nick Foligno!
To choose friend or adversary.
This one's my pick. It'll give everyone a good chance to really boo here. Phil Kessel.
It's nice to have my teammate at my back up here.
Teammate or countryman?
We're extremely proud to pick Erik Karlsson.
In a room full of stars, one will shine brightest as the first player chosen, while one will be left as the last man standing. It's the third NHL All-Star Game Player Fantasy Draft, and it starts now. City of Columbus and the Columbus Blue Jackets hosting the NHL All-Star Weekend for the very first time as the stars, the biggest and brightest ones in the National Hockey League, have come together here in this great city in Columbus. Hello everybody and welcome to the 2015 NHL Fantasy All-Star Draft. What a crowd we have here at the Convention Center in downtown Columbus. I'm Catherine Tappan, happy to have you all with us.
And I'm Darren Millard. You know, players are creatures of habit, Catherine. They know when they're going to play. They know who they're going to play against. They usually know who they're going to line up with on the ice. That is not the case because only six players arrived in Columbus knowing which team they were going to play for. The rest are assignable. And those captains and alternates all have teammates back there waiting to be picked. So what do? Do you take your buddy or do you go in a different direction? That latter part has caused some tensions in the previous two fantasy drafts.
Lots of tension, lots of nerves, lots of anticipation for this. A sparkling Honda Accord to my right that will be handed out at the end of the night. But of course, let's get right to it. We have two captains to introduce you to. And first, it is the captain of the opposing, the away team. Yep. It's Jonathan Toews. He's the captain of the Chicago Blackhawks, and he is captain of Team Toews here this weekend. Jonathan Toews in his eighth NHL season. He is the third leading vote getter in the National Hockey League for the All-Star Game. A two-time Stanley Cup champ. Jonathan, what the heck was with all the booze there?
Well, that's kind of what we're going to expect for the rest of the weekend. So we're taking on that role and we're proud of it.
It's your third All-Star Game, but of course this is your first time. You talk about roles as the role of captain. So do you have a strategy coming into this night?
Well, I've been talking with Ryan Getzlaf and Rick Nash for the last 20 minutes, and I think we're going with the no strategy strategy right now.
20 minutes? You're putting a lot into that.
Yeah, a little too much, maybe.
Well, the Chicago Blackhawks had five of the top six NHL vote-getters for the All-Star Game here this weekend. What does that tell you about your fans in Chicago?
Well, we got great fans. It's an amazing city and a great organization, but the five of us are great. Very appreciative and very happy to be here in Columbus. Used to come here a lot when we were in the same division, so should be a lot of fun. A lot of fun this weekend. A lot of great fans here in Columbus as well.
All right, well, we're going to get the fun started. We're going to have you go to the podium right over there. Take your mark at your laptop to get busy. And who else is on deck for the captains?
The captain of the home team from the Columbus Blue Jackets, Nick Foligno. That C looks pretty good.
Yeah, it feels good. Feels good.
So you're a first-time All-Star, and they also make you pick the team. No sliding through this weekend.
Yeah, they just wanted to put all the pressure on me all at once here, so I'm taking it in stride. I'm going to have a lot of fun with this.
Now, are you a guy that plays a lot of fantasy sports?
Not really, to be honest with you. So this will be pretty interesting. I'm gonna delegate to a lot of my assistants on this one.
Have you put more than 20 minutes in that Jonathan Toews has researched?
I think I put about 21. So is that good? I don't know. We'll see. But I'm feeling good about our chances here.
Well, congratulations. Look forward to the night and have some fun. Okay. Send you over to the podium. There's the captain of Team Foligno.
Already some trash talking here. Yep. He's got 21 minutes. Toews has 20. Well, they're not alone up there on the podium. Both captains will be flanked by their assistant captains. And we begin with Team Toews. We introduce you to the captain of the Anaheim Ducks, Ryan Getzlaff. He will be an alternate captain for Team Toews. Ryan Getzlaff is in his 10th NHL season, third All-Star appearance. This season, he leads the team in assists and points, and of course, he won the Stanley Cup back in 2007. And a familiar name here in Columbus. Curious to see what happens here when we bring out the other alternate captain, Rick Nash of the New York Rangers.
That's the response.
Rick Nash played 9 seasons here in Columbus. He now is with the New York Rangers in the Big Apple, and he has 28 goals on the season. That ties with Tyler Seguin, who is also here tonight, for the most goals in the National Hockey League. So, some big stars on the stage and more to come.
Assisting Nick Foligno from the Chicago Blackhawks, his second time around as an alternate captain at the fantasy draft, Patrick Kane. Patrick, by the way, was drafted first overall in Columbus back in 2007, and you've got 2 Blackhawks on alternate sides.
Are you messing up his hair over there? Is that what you're doing?
Rounding out Team Foligno from the Los Angeles Kings, Drew Doughty. Drew Doughty, 2-time Stanley Cup champion, 2-time Olympian, and yet that is his first time at the All-Star game. Well-deserved.
All right, so lots to get to tonight, including a lot of action backstage where probably most of the trash talking is going on. That's where we find Pierre Maguire. Hey, Pierre.
Hello, Catherine. Hello, Darren. All right, you're familiar with going first overall 2006 with Sarnia, first overall in the Ontario Hockey League draft, first overall in the 2008 NHL draft. What's it like to go first overall?
It's good. It's bragging rights. You always want to be the best at what you do, so I've been fortunate to have that experience before, and look forward to have some fun tonight.
Your general manager in Tampa, Steve Yzerman, knows a lot about team building. If you were building a team for the All-Star game, what would you be looking to do?
Ooh, I think you need a good goaltender. You got a lot of good players out there. You need someone that can stop the puck. I know we got a lot of good goaltenders here tonight, so we'll see how it goes down.
Have a blast this weekend, Steven.
Thank you.
Catherine, Darren, back to you.
All right, Pierre. So Steven Stamkos would take a goaltender. Guess what? All of you can get involved at home, here in the audience. The players can get involved backstage. We want to know who you think is going to go number one overall here at the Fantasy Draft. Go to NBCSports.com/vote. Here are your choices. Alex Ovechkin, Steven Stamkos, Claude Giroux, or Carey Price. Let your voice be known. We'll find out what the answer is right after the break. The star one overall pick back in the 2012 All-Star Game. We asked you, the fans at home here in attendance, and the players backstage, who would you take first overall? And looks like Steven Stamkos, perhaps 32%. It's fluctuating a lot. We'll have to wait and find out who takes the first overall. Let's go backstage to Pierre Maguire as he is standing by with Alex Ovechkin.
Thanks very much, Catherine. Well, you're close. Are you angry if you don't go number one?
I want to be last. I need a car, so.
Do you remember what you did the last time we had an All-Star game and there was a draft? Do you have your camera ready?
Yeah. Phil Kessel sit at my table, so we're all set.
Are you having fun this weekend so far?
Kind of.
When you think about the All-Star experience and you've been through it a number of times, what's the one thing that you learn every time you come here?
Just skill competition. You see that what's different guys doing, and you know, after that, nighttime.
Congrats on a great start to the year. Have fun this weekend, Alex.
Yeah, thanks.
Darren, Catherine, back to you.
All right, Pierre, thank you. Well, it looks like 30%. That is a final. Steven Stamkos, according to the fans and the players and all of you in attendance, is going to go first overall. So I don't know. Would you guys agree with that?
I don't know. I got to consult my two buddies over there.
Hold on.
I don't know if you're going first yet.
I don't know. Ovechkin says he wants to go last because he wants a car. You going to give him what he wants?
No.
whatever Obi-Wan, that's all we can have.
All right.
I would be shocked if Alex Ovechkin is not taken by these two before that car gets handed out, but...
Ovi, you got your message right there, your answer.
He's the first game you play after the break.
Oh, the first game you play after the break, so that's why you can't give him what he wants. Before you guys get into the first pick, we want to lay down some ground rules. And you can't just take 17 forwards out here and try and win the game 20-2. You have to take three goaltenders. That's obvious. Six in attendance. There is six defensemen per team, and you have to draft at least 11 forwards. All goaltenders have to be gone by the end of the 10th round, and all defensemen must be picked by the end of the 15th round, so we know a forward will go last.
And I have a puck here. It says the All-Star game on one side, that's going to be heads. It says NHL on the other, that is going to be tails. So let's flip this, and Nick, you can do us the honors and call
it. I'm going to say you got to go with All-Star game heads.
Yeah.
And he wins. It is the All-Star game. Team Foligno is picking first. Jonathan, you're going to have to wait one pick to find out who your number one pick is. Let's send you both to your podiums.
And Team Foligno is on the clock.
Your alternate captains. And it's Team Foligno.
Pavel Datsyuk and Cam Ward have gone first overall in the previous two.
But they're not here.
Fantasy drafts.
They're not here, Darren. Who is it going to be?
Well, when you look at former teammates or current teammates, Ryan Johansson plays on a line with
But does
Nick
there
Cleese.
Become a strategy where they want to pick their teammates or they don't want to pick their teammates or the other guy wants to grab their teammates?
Are you ready?
Yeah, I think so. Do we announce?
Go to it.
Oh, boy.
With the first selection of this 2015 All-Star Draft, we are proud to select from the hometown team, Ryan Johansson.
From the Columbus Blue Jackets, Ryan Johansson is the only NHL player this season to put together 2-point streaks of 10 games or more. This season, he set a franchise record by recording points in 13 consecutive games.
Pass to me.
Nick, stay over here. Nick, stay over here. This is a no-brainer, right?
Yeah, it was pretty easy. We got some good chemistry, and I had to convince the guys over there, but they were pretty good about it, so.
You're welcome.
Were you nervous at all that your buddy might not take you?
Well, if Foligno wasn't picking, I'd be cruising around Columbus in one of those, so.
You called him the best player you've ever played with last week. That made it pretty simple that you were going to take him.
Yeah, you know what, we really enjoy playing together, and he's a great player. He's going to be in a lot of these for a lot of years to come, I think, so I'm glad to have him as the first pick.
Ryan Johansson, the first pick in the 2015 NHL All-Star Fantasy Draft. Hey, we got to separate you at some point.
Team Taves.
You want to jump in there?
Hey, Dewey, I just wanted to make sure you knew this wasn't the Price is Right.
All right, now that we got that straightened out, we would like to pick with our first pick of the draft from the Toronto Maple Leafs, Phil Kessel.
From the Toronto Maple Leafs, Phil Kessel leads his Maple Leaf teammates in points with 19 goals and 25 assists. He's previously played in two NHL All-Star games and one NHL Young Stars game.
Phil, I'm going to let you get your jersey on here. Jonathan, stay out here with me for a second. No shiny 2015 Honda Accord for you this year.
I guess not, right?
Is it a bit of relief for you?
It's all right. I picked last one, so I didn't care if I get picked again last.
Jonathan, what was the strategy behind this? Was it skill set? Was it didn't want to make him feel any better, worse than before?
Well, it's a little bit of everything. We know that Phil had a tough one a couple years ago. I think he deserved to... be at the top end of the draft this year, and I think the three of us were just talking that he's one of the most coachable players out there, so we're happy to have him on our team.
All right, good pick. Phil, congratulations. Welcome to Team Taves, and Nick Foligno, you are on the clock.
We did pick a forward, so should we try? I don't know. I guess we got to. Is this on?
yeah, it's on.
Oh, God.
Okay. Want to go with Keith?
Yeah. Good choice.
It's a choice.
Guess I shouldn't have told Taser who I wanted for a first pick. Figured he'd take all my ideas. But for our second pick, we'll take from the Chicago Blackhawks, number 2, Duncan Keith.
From the Chicago Blackhawks, Duncan Keith is a 2-time Stanley Cup, 2-time Norris Trophy, and 2-time Olympic gold medal winner. He played in his 700th career NHL game on November 7th, all with the Blackhawks.
The 2-time Stanley Cup winner is the first defenseman chosen here at the Fantasy Draft. It's his 3rd All-Star game this season, 27 points. He's played in 46 of the 47 games played for the Chicago Blackhawks.
So the assistant captain scoops his teammate from his team captain with the Chicago Blackhawks. Just want to remind you guys, Jonathan, Nick, you can make a trade if you so be. Want to go down that route, but there's only one trade in the fantasy draft. We've never had one of the 3 times we've done this, so we're kind of looking for some history here.
I heard he's a beauty. All right,
Team Taves.
Fuck now, you're saying?
Yes.
Okay. It's a twist. Well, we should take Kopitar, I guess, because that's going to be your guys' next pick, right? You guys can pick players from other teams, hey? Our second pick, we're going to take Shea Weber from the Nashville Predators.
Captain of the Nashville Predators, Shea Weber is playing in his 4th NHL All-Star game. He's been a Norris Trophy finalist in 3 of the past 4 seasons.
Back-to-back defenseman chosen here at the Fantasy Draft, a 4-time All-Star, Shea Weber, the captain of the Nashville Predators. He's got 30 points this season. And coming off a career year, he tied a career high in goals, set career high in assists and points. It is Shea Weber going to Team Taves. That leaves Team Foligno with the pick.
All right, with the 3rd pick, I would pick my boy, Anze Kopitar.
From the Los Angeles Kings, Anze Kopitar's game-winning goal on January 12th was the 30th of his brilliant career.
Anze Kopitar, 2-time Stanley Cup champion. Let you put your jersey on. So, they're beaking you pretty good over there.
Who? Yeah, I don't know why they're after me. I got a lot on Getzy. I'm just holding on to it for later rounds here.
Does that go back to the playoffs last year?
Of course. We got him good there. He didn't have much the whole series. I shut him down pretty nice.
Kopi, come back here. Did you lobby at all for a pick here?
No, not really. I think Dewey, I figure he would be a good guy and pick me, hopefully second to last, but you know.
Everybody wants the car now.
I guess so, but there's some guys that want it really bad back there, so we'll see.
Team Mix really is the run here for Team Foligno. Thanks for doing this, guys. Team Taves.
What is it again? It's D-men by
15, goalies by 10. Yeah.
With their 3rd pick, we'll take the leading scorer in the NHL, Jake Voracek.
From the Philadelphia Flyers, Jakub Voracek currently leads the entire NHL in points and assists. This season, he became the first Flyer since Chris Pronger in 2011 to score at least 1 point in each of the team's first 5 games.
Jake Voracek, the only Philadelphia Flyer to lead the National Hockey League in scoring, and he is headed to Team Taves. We are headed to our first commercial break. Don't go anywhere. Lots more to come here on the Fantasy Draft. Alex Ovechkin still available. Steven Stamkos behind him still available. Who will go next? We'll find out after the break. An overall pick back in the tooth now for Team Taves and Team Foligno. Team Foligno not going far from the barn here. They've got all members of either the Hawks, the Kings, or the Blue Jackets on their team. 2 defensemen, no goaltenders, though some goalies need to be chosen here. They have to be picked by round number 10. Let's take a look at Team Taves. They have 1 defenseman, Shea Weber. Nash, Kessel, Voracek, some big scoring guys on that team. We'll have to find out how the rest of it shapes up. Let's go backstage now as Pierre is joined by a goaltender who is still up for grabs. Pierre.
Thanks very much, Catherine. You're a shrewd evaluator of NHL talent. What do you think of both teams so far?
Oh, pretty good. I think one team's doing the buddy system and the other one's going for some strategy. So, you know, Taser knows how good I am in the room. So, you know, just trying to make a case for myself here.
Which team would you prefer to stand behind?
Yeah. Well, my kids really like the white jersey. So, you know, I'm trying to, you know, please them so I can get them a nice white jersey with the one on the back.
And what's the hardest part about being a goalie in the All-Star game?
Well, stopping the puck, I would say. It's not something that's easy to do when there's so much talent on the ice and defense is not really important.
Thanks for doing this, Roberto. Have fun this weekend. Catherine.
All right, Pierre, thank you. A little lobbying there for Team Taves, but it's Team Foligno that's on the clock. So, Nick, you and Patrick and Drew, you've got to make a decision. Is it going to be Roberto Luongo? Are you going to steal him from his Team Taves?
Are you married?
What's going on?
You're on the clock,
oh,
Nick.
On the clock. Sorry, we were just chatting strategy.
It sounded like it.
Yeah, with our next pick, we're very surprised this guy's gone this long without being picked. From Tampa Bay Lightning, Steven Stamkos.
Captain of the Tampa Bay Lightning, Steven Stamkos is a two-time winner of the Rocket Richard Trophy, playing in his third NHL All-Star game. On December 10th, he became the 10th youngest player in history to score his 250th NHL goal.
Put on your sweater. Stick with me for a bit. So, first overall pick when you came into the NHL, then you slipped down to 7th overall. Are you disappointed?
A little bit. No, I think I was around the same spot last time, so I'm happy to go to the home team here. Couple ex-OHL players over there sticking together, so I appreciate it. Uncle Louie.
Oh, Louie.
Now, the first time to this time, going through this process, is it different?
You know what, it's a lot of fun. I think guys have some fun within the backstage. I know everyone says they want the car, but they don't really want the car, so I'm happy I don't have a chance for the car tonight.
Have you ever played golf with Drew Doughty?
I haven't. I think we want to get around together. He says he's a 6 handicap. I don't believe it, but we'll see this summer.
Press him on the tee, okay? That's when you would beat him. Thanks for this.
Thank you.
Team Taves.
All right, I'm going to be a little homer here, and we're going to go with a goaltender, first goaltender of the draft, and we're going to take, from the Chicago Blackhawks, Corey Crawford.
From the Chicago Blackhawks, Corey Crawford ranks first in save percentage in the history of Blackhawks goaltenders. He's a Stanley Cup champion, as well as a William M. Jennings Trophy winner.
Corey Crawford making his first All-Star game appearance this season. He is 18-10-2, a 2.26 goals against, and a .921 save percentage. He won the Stanley Cup with Jonathan Taves in 2013 for the Chicago Blackhawks in his 8th NHL season. Corey Crawford, congratulations, your first All-Star game. So Corey Crawford goes to Team Taves. Team Foligno still has yet to choose a goaltender, and guys, you are back on the clock.
Do whatever you want.
All right, with our next pick, I played with him in Switzerland. Probably one of the most gifted players I ever played with. We'll take Tyler Seguin.
From the Dallas Stars, Tyler Seguin comes into the All-Star game tied for tops in the NHL in goals with 28. He's scored multiple goals in a league-leading 7 games this season.
So you've got Steven Stamkos, one of the top goal scorers in the National Hockey League. Patrick, get back over here. Come on over. Let's have a chat. And now, leading goal scorer in the National Hockey League, and Tyler Seguin. What do you like about playing with him?
Well, he told me before the draft that he's going to pass me the puck, so.
You know he's a shooter, though, right?
I've seen him pass. He's a good passer, too.
So this was prearranged?
A little bit. I told him before I'd be willing to back check, so I don't know if I had any influence there, too.
Lindy's listening too, you know that.
That's why I said it.
Congratulations, appreciate it. Team Taves.
Oh, hold on a second. I'm surprised Drew Doughty didn't recognize the shoes on Tyler Seguin. Do Seguin and Stamkos have the same shoes on?
Oh, sorry, we're over here. Yeah.
Hey, Drew, you dropped the ball on that one.
Stole my shoes and my number.
He's not paying attention at all, by the way.
Are you guys?
All right, Team Taves, you're on the clock.
Classic. All right.
No,
we're going to go with a good two-way forward here. We got a lot of offense going on our team here. We're going to go with Jonathan Tavares.
The captain of the New York Islanders, John Tavares, ranks second this season across the NHL in game-winning goals and fourth in power play goals. This past November, he broke the Islanders' franchise record for overtime goals with five, then scored one more in January.
In his sixth NHL season, this is John Tavares' second All-Star game. He leads the team in goals and points. He is the captain of the New York Islanders, and what a season the Islanders are having this year, Darren. Top of the Eastern Conference, and he's on the other team as Steven Stamkos, whose team is also atop the Eastern Conference standings.
A lot of 91s. Team Foligno. I'm starting to sense here, Doughty and Nash are the two guys that are trying to distract everybody else. Is that true over there?
What was that?
Trying to just... No more questions.
Yeah. All right. With our next pick, we pick from the Montreal Canadiens, Carey Price.
From the Montreal Canadiens, Carey Price is making his fourth NHL All-Star Game appearance. He won a gold medal at the 2014 Olympic Games, where he was named Best Goaltender.
Couple of Olympic teammates standing beside each other. Carey Price is the first goaltender selected by Team Foligno. Back to Team Taves.
All right, our next pick is based on not disappointing his kids tonight, and he has the most gel in his hair in the NHL Hockey League. Roberto Luongo.
From the Florida Panthers, Roberto Luongo currently ranks second among active NHL goaltenders in wins, shutouts, and saves. He's making his fifth NHL All-Star Game appearance.
You don't have to.
Let you put this jersey on here. Were you lobbying for Team Taves back there with Pierre?
Yeah, I had to.
You've been like,
I don't want to disappoint the kids, right?
I don't know.
That's right. What is this with the most gel in the hair? I mean, are you going to take that from them?
This is not gel. This is natural oil, guys. Come on.
So, one, two, three.
Are the kids having fun here?
Yeah, they are. It's their first time, so it's a good experience for me to live it through them, you know?
All right, so you are going to Team Taves. We are going to take a short break here. Which team looks better? We are going to ask you guys, the fans at home, all of you in the audience, and you can start your voting by going to nbcsports.com/vote. Is it Team Foligno or Team Taves? We'll find out at the 2015 Fantasy NHL Draft right after this. For Team Taves and Team. Come back, everybody, to the 2015 NHL Fantasy Draft at the All-Star Game. We've asked you to go on to nbcsports.com/vote to tell us which team you think looks better so far, and it's swaying in Team Taves' favor at 57%. Well, get involved. Get those tablets out. Start voting. Let's go backstage. One player who hasn't been picked yet is Alex Ovechkin, and I don't know, Pierre, what's going on back there?
Well, thank you, Catherine. Where are all your friends?
I don't know. I'm by myself here, so I'm pretty happy.
I don't think you are. I saw you on your phone. Who were you texting?
I just put on Instagram some pictures, me and you.
Okay, you've had a chance to evaluate both teams. Who do you want to pick you?
I want to be last. I need a car so bad, like, that I need it.
I think you might get it.
Thanks God.
Darren, Catherine, back to you.
Geez, I wonder who that was behind that piece of paper. Alexander Ovechkin remains available, but we have gone through six rounds of this 2015 NHL All-Star Fantasy Draft, presented by DraftKings. And for Team Foligno, you have the likes of Tyler Seguin and Steven Stamkos going back-to-back. Carey Price is the only goaltender that Team Foligno has selected so far. For Team Taves, Phil Kessel was their first selection, and they have two goaltenders, Corey Crawford and Roberto Luongo. Back to Catherine.
Yeah, I'm here in the stands because Drew Doughty noticed Steven Stamkos' shoes, and I happen to notice that Tyler Seguin has the same shoes, so I'm just curious if you guys planned this.
No, we just planned to be the best dressed guys here and started with our shoes.
So, no phone conversations beforehand, Steven?
No, we just obviously have pretty good fashion sense, so.
Are you surprised that Drew Doughty recognized the shoe? I mean, he's not even paying attention over there. He pays attention to shoes, though.
Very surprised that Drew, he's not even paying attention right now.
Can you put the shoe up on the bar so everyone can see the shoe? You might have to stand. But I mean, there's like sparkly stuff on the sides, bedazzled, and it's not a typical hockey shoe.
You know what, you can dress them up or dress them down. Very diverse and versatile, so a good.
Hey, is this NHL Network or E?
It's a hybrid shoe. All right, dress it up, dress it down. The teams are dressed up, and Team Foligno, you're back on the clock. Drew, you don't have a pair of these on, do you?
Can't afford them.
All right, well, go pick your next player.
I feel bad for you, Drew. All right, with our next pick, I think we're going to sway the fans back in our favor for the better team here. From the Philadelphia Flyers, Claude Giroux.
The captain of the Philadelphia Flyers, Claude Giroux, leads the Flyers in faceoff percentage this season after winning 82% in a November 22nd game. This is his third NHL All-Star Game appearance.
Claude Giroux's third All-Star game, currently third in NHL scoring. Captain of the Philadelphia Flyers, was a first-round pick back in 2006. Claude Giroux joins Team Foligno. Team Taves, it's over to you.
All right, well, I have the privilege of picking right before Kaner every time, and I think he wants Brent Seabrook and Duncan Keith as a pairing, so I'm going to play right into that, and I'm going to take from the Chicago Blackhawks, Brent Seabrook.
From the Chicago Blackhawks, Brent Seabrook recorded a career-high 7-game point streak this past November. He was the second defenseman voted into this year's NHL All-Star Game with more than 1 million votes.
Patrick, if you do want Duncan and Brent together, just lean over there and try and swing a trade. See if we can come up with something.
There has never been a trade at the fantasy draft. You can do it tonight. Team Foligno, Team Taves, you have to coordinate, be the GMs for a little bit and figure out which trade you want to move, but it can happen. So if you do want those two defensemen together, you can do it. All right, it's Team Foligno on the clock.
Are you going with that? Stick a buff? Like that? Combat, shape
like. All right, I think we have a dark horse here for the hardest shot. We'll take next, maybe someone to combat Shea Weber. So we're gonna take Dustin Byfuglien from the Winnipeg Jets.
Former Byfuglien.
From the Winnipeg Jets, Dustin Byfuglien is a Stanley Cup winner who leads his Winnipeg Jets in shots this season.
Now, Steven Stamkos, the guy's getting some serious credit for the shoes that they're wearing tonight.
Sorry, man.
Buff, you're going to top them all this weekend, aren't you? I hear a rumor about a special edition pair of skates that you've designed, that you've modeled, and you're going to unveil them this weekend.
Yeah, they're the master jerseys. They're, you know, skates I wear the VH. They're master skates.
So you came up with the color scheme, a little neon, some white in there and some black?
Yeah, I dabbled a little bit with it.
Now, is it true, though, that you told Team Taves that you wanted to go to the Team White, the white sweaters, because your skates would look better in their uniforms?
Yeah, that is true.
I had no idea there was so much fashion talk going on. Thanks for doing this. Team Foligno, you need a goalie. Keep that in mind. Back to Team Taves.
Hold on. Oh, you're the guy. Oh.
Yes.
Oh, we're on the clock.
Yes, you're on the clock. You're chit-chatting a lot over there, though. We want to know what are you talking about?
We're trying to figure out how to say everybody's name.
Do you need a little help?
That means Demgus is next?
that's not easy to do. You guys have a
tell
tough
me
job.
About it.
Yeah, I bet. We are going to go. We need another sniper on our team. We're going to go with Tarasenko.
That would be Vladimir Tarasenko of the St. Louis Blues.
From the St. Louis Blues, Vladimir Tarasenko is currently ranked in the top five across the NHL in both goals and plus minus this season. This season, he became the first Blue with two hat tricks since Brett Hall did it in the 96-97 season.
And Vladimir Tarasenko, it's his first All-Star game. One of five players this season with 20 goals and 20 plus assists. Last season, 21 goals, 22 assists, playing in his third NHL season, and some highlight reel performances this year for the St. Louis Blues. So it is Vladimir Tarasenko going to Team Taves.
He was a lot better at finding the net than he was finding the stage right now.
Team Foligno, you're on the clock, and the rounds are ticking. You're going to have to pick another goaltender soon. I know you can lean heavily on Carey Price. We've seen that happen before, but you do need another goaltender.
All right. All right, with our next selection from the Pittsburgh Penguins, we select Marc-Andre Fleury.
From the Pittsburgh Penguins, earlier this season at age 29, Marc-Andre Fleury became the third youngest and third fastest goalie to win his 300th NHL game. He leads all NHL goalies this season with a career-high six shutouts.
Stay over here, stay over here. You're kind of, you're carrying the Penguin colors without Sid and Jenny Malkin.
Yeah, a little disappointed to not have them with me here, but, you know, I'm just trying to make the best out of it, have some fun.
Now you're the loose guy. You don't fall into that sort of goaltending mentality. You're going to have fun. How do you adapt to this? Is there just a fun time out there?
Yeah, you know, you don't want to get lit up too much, but, you know, I think you got to enjoy your time, try some fun with the guys out there, and that's what the weekend's about.
How much is this different than the first time around?
I don't know. We'll see over the weekend. You know, it's still early, so, well, looking forward to it.
Marc-Andre, thank you.
Thank you.
All right, we're going to take a short break here on the 2015 NHL All-Star Draft presented by DraftKings. Lots more players available, many of them still backstage, anxiously hoping to go to a team. Look at them all. We'll be back with more after this. Welcome back, everybody, to the 2000
Fantasy Draft presented by DraftKings. And remember, one lucky player tonight will win this brand new 2015 Honda Accord. Honda, well known in Ohio. They've been producing Accords in the Buckeye State for the past 32 years. To complete the ninth round, here is Team Taves.
We're going to go with one of the best players in the league that can do it all, from the Boston Bruins, Patrice Bergeron.
From the Boston Bruins, Patrice Bergeron's career achievements include winning the Frank J. Selke Trophy, Olympic gold, and the Stanley Cup. In this, his 11th season, Patrice Bergeron recorded his 500th career point this past October.
A two-time Selke Trophy winner, the 2011 Stanley Cup champion, and the most recent member of the Triple Gold Club, making his first All-Star appearance, Patrice Bergeron joins Team Taves. And let's take a look, Darren, after nine rounds, where do we stand with these teams?
Team Foligno with a couple of goaltenders, but remember the rules. You have to have all goaltenders selected by the end of the 10th round, so I think I know what's coming. There's two goaltenders remain available, Yaroslav Halak and Brian Elliott. And interesting on Team Taves, they have both the Selke winners that are taking part in this 2015 All-Star Weekend. They also need to round out their goaltending situation. Back on the clock, Team Foligno, you need a goaltender, Halak or Elliott? Team Foligno, you need a goaltender?
Can't hear you. Sorry. Having too good of a time up here. With our next pick, it's a guy I played with, broke in my rookie year with him in Ottawa, Brian Elliott. He's not here, but great goaltender.
Brian Elliott is an injury replacement. Found out at the last minute he is not here, but will be present here in Columbus for the skills competition tomorrow night and the All-Star game on Sunday afternoon. Brian Elliott of the St. Louis Blues goes to Team Foligno.
Team Taves.
Yeah, this is pretty obvious, right?
I think so.
Well, I think if we got the rules straight, we got to pick a goaltender, and none better than Yaroslav Halak.
From the New York Islanders, Yaroslav Halak is tied for third in wins and tied for fourth in shutouts among all NHL goalies this season. On January 13th, he led the Islanders to a shutout of the New York Rangers at MSG for the first time since 1975.
Making his first All-Star appearance, Yaroslav Halak leading the New York Islanders this season to the top of the Eastern Conference. Signed with the offseason on the island, and it's worked out so far so good for Yaroslav Halak. And he joins his current teammate and the captain of the New York Islanders, John Tavares.
Elliott and Halak go back-to-back. They won
Jennings Trophy together, that's right.
In 2012. Team Foligno.
All right, with our next pick, we're going to take the second best, number 88 in the league, Brent Burns.
From the San Jose Sharks, Brent Burns recorded his 200th career NHL assist and 300th career NHL point this season.
Brent Burns, hybrid, forward. Defenseman. If you would have won the car, would you have traded it in for some teeth?
No. It's the beard and teeth help keep the wife at bay a little bit.
What kind of look are you going for here?
Caveman, Chewbacca. I've heard a lot of things. I don't know. It's pretty unique.
Well, I think you're succeeding. Good job.
Thank you.
There's Brent Burns.
All right, Jonathan Taves, Rick Nash, Ryan Getzlaff, you guys are back on the clock.
All right. I had the pleasure of having breakfast with this guy this morning. First time I met him, Aaron Ekblad from the Florida Panthers.
From the Florida Panthers, earlier this season, Aaron Ekblad became the youngest defenseman in franchise history to score his first NHL goal. Already this season, he set Panther franchise records for both points and assists for a rookie defenseman.
Aaron, congratulations. Let you get your jersey on there. You were chosen to join this All-Star roster. You are a rookie, but you get to play in the game due to some injuries, and you get picked by a guy who's won a Stanley Cup, and you're joining Stanley Cup contenders as well. How's it feel up here?
It's pretty exciting for sure. Obviously, first time doing this, and very lucky to have been picked by Ryan Getzlaff. Yeah, pretty excited. Fun.
So Ryan said he had breakfast with you today, the first time he's met you. So how does that conversation get started? Who gets whose number first? How do you know how to meet up with breakfast with a guy you've never met before?
I awkwardly walked into the breakfast room, and he offered me a seat. One of the nicer guys in the room today.
All right, Aaron, congratulations. You are joining Team Taves, and we are going to take a short break here at the 2015 NHL Fantasy Draft presented by DraftKings. We will introduce you to the youngest stars in the National Hockey League coming up after the break. Welcome back, everybody, to the 2015.
Back in Columbus, the 2015 NHL Fantasy Draft presented by DraftKings. Darren Millard along with Catherine Tappan. There's 19 first-time All-Stars participating in this year's event. Plus, we've got four rookies to take part. Now, this is the way it's going to work. They're in twos, and they're going to be picked in their tandems. Jonathan Duran, the Tampa Bay Lightning, Memorial Cup champion, scored his first NHL goal this year, has 18 points right up there among the rookie leaders in with assists with 16, and he is paired with Jiří Šehek, 22-year-old, undrafted, but worked his way into the Montreal Canadiens' sights and earned a job at a training camp and is part of the Montreal Canadiens right now. So Jiří Šehek and Jonathan Drouin are a tandem.
And the other tandem, Mike Hoffman of the Ottawa Senators, leads the team in goals and also first among NHL rookies in scoring as well. And Johnny Gaudreau to my left of the Calgary Flames, the Hobey Baker winner last year out of Boston College. Did I hear it right? Are you trying to trademark the term Johnny Hockey?
My agent is, but yeah.
All right, there you have it. Right out of the horse's mouth.
These four will participate in the skills competition on Saturday afternoon, and because Team Taves lost the initial puck flip, it was Team Foligno that got to pick first, so Team Taves gets the initial choice among the rookies.
That's not right.
I don't agree with that.
Well, this is a tough one. A lot of talent there. But we're going to have to go with Johnny Gaudreau and Mike Hoffman. Let's do it, guys.
Johnny Gaudreau and Mike Hoffman will participate in the skills competition for Team Taves. Gary Sakach and Jonathan Duran will participate for Team Foligno.
Congratulations, guys. How does it feel going to Team Taves?
I'm going to go shake their hand. Let's go all shake.
Yeah, cool.
Yeah? Do you guys have any tricks up your sleeve for the skills competition tomorrow?
Nothing too much. No, it'll be a good event. Looking forward to it.
Great job. All right, let's take a look at those rosters right now and see how things are shaping up for these teams here on stage. Team Taves, Team Foligno, still a lot of work to do. Let's take a look at Team Taves first, and there are some defenseman holes there. Three more defensemen need to be chosen. The goaltenders are all rounded up and accounted for, and three forwards for Team Taves. Taking a look at Team Foligno, the captain of the home team. Let's take a look at what needs to be filled for them. A couple of defensemen as well as some forwards. All right, so lots more work to be done. It looks like they may be working on a trade over here.
It's worked out in the past.
Just to eavesdrop a little bit.
It's worked out in the past for both teams, so okay, all right.
Sounds good.
Do we have anything to announce?
You're up.
I've always wanted to do this. We have a trade to announce. It's worked out for both teams in the past, so we're going to go with history here, and we're going to trade Tyler Seguin for Phil Kessel.
A little bit of history repeating here.
I hope that's okay.
Do you see the sense of humor here?
And 15 first-round draft picks.
All right, well, you got to get up. You got to get over there.
I'm sorry, Phil.
Say your goodbyes. Tyler, did you see this coming at all?
You never expect to get traded. It's tough to swallow right now, but I'm really excited. A big opportunity over there with White, so it'll be fun.
It's deja vu all over again for you two. All right, so Tyler Seguin, you are now going to be number 91, although now there's two 91s over here, so how's that going to work? We'll figure that out later, I guess. Phil Kessel goes to Team Foligno, who is now back on the clock after making the trade.
Oh, my God. That was a tough trade. I just want to say it was a tough trade.
Your first one always is, right?
No,
they
got one more.
All right, I'm picking this guy solely on how good his hair is. From the St. Louis Blues, Kevin Shattenkirk.
From the St. Louis Blues, Kevin Shattenkirk currently shares the NHL lead in power play points with 24. He also currently leads all NHL defensemen in assists with 31 and is second among defensemen in points.
So, did you realize that you had this much admiration for your hair?
There's not much admiration for my hair, I'm not going to lie. But, you know, doubts makes up for it, and just happy to be sharing this moment with him.
So you're okay with him taking a pick just to give you a shot?
Always, yeah. Always. I'll have my moment someday.
Thanks for doing this. Team Taves.
Yeah.
We got a good leadership guy for the dressing room, one of the most respected guys in the NHL. Ranger fans won't be happy, but from the Devils, Patrick Elias.
From the New Jersey Devils, two-time Stanley Cup champion Patrick Elias recorded his 600th NHL assist and 1,000th NHL point earlier this month. His next regular season NHL goal will be the 400th of his career.
Over 1,000 points for Patrick Elias, making his fourth All-Star game. The two-time Stanley Cup winner in his 19th NHL season happens to be the oldest player at the fantasy draft, but he looks like one of the younger guys as Patrick Elias is going to Team Taves, and that means Team Foligno, you are back on the clock.
Patrick Elias played his first game in the league before Ekblad was born.
That's right.
That's a good point. That's
thank you.
All right, with our next pick, we're going with an Ottawa boy, Bobby Ryan.
From the Ottawa Senators, coming into the All-Star break, Bobby Ryan is tied for the lead in points on the Sens. He also was a 2009 Calder Trophy nominee and is making his first NHL All-Star game appearance.
Five career, 20-goal seasons, and he's well on his way to number six, the second overall pick in 2005. Bobby Ryan is a member of Team Foligno. Team Taves, you're up.
Yeah. Team Taves, you have to take a defenseman. You've been avoiding them. You love your goal scorers, but you're going to have to take a defenseman.
All right. You forced our hand. We're going to go try and put an old D pairing together. We're thinking Ryan Suter.
Minnesota Wild, Ryan Suter comes into the NHL All-Star game leading the entire league in time on ice per game. In December, he skated his 700th NHL game.
Ryan Suter of the Minnesota Wild will join Team Taves, play on the same team as Shea Weber, his longtime defensive partner with the Nashville Predators. Some strategy there. The final picks are coming up, and look who's still there. Happy as can be. Ordering his keys. Alexander Ovechkin. Back in Columbus, Canada. Backstage where the numbers have dwindled to Pierre.
Thanks very much, Darren. You've been through this before, Mark. You were never drafted coming out of junior. You're playing in the
state. I'm still here.
Ovi's still here. How are you handling this?
By any car.
I have a great chance to still get drafted ahead of Alex Ovechkin, so I feel great right now.
I think that's so bad.
So bad.
Sell yourself to Foligno or Taves. What would you bring to their team?
I don't know.
Foligno, I'm here.
A lot, I guess.
Jonathan, they're there for you. He's here for you. Both of them are here for you.
Come on, guys.
No, I'm going to go.
No. He wants the car. He doesn't want to get picked.
Team Can we Foligno. Just give him the car?
No. Oh, you got to earn it. You got to get left.
Get it out of the way. Here's what's happened so far tonight. Team Foligno's roster looks like this. The goaltenders are taken care of. One more defenseman. Team Foligno has five more picks. For Team Taves, it's four more selections, but like in the salary cap world, sometimes you can put yourself in a bit of a bind. They have to take two defensemen with their next two picks. Team Foligno, you are on the clock. Drew, Nick, Patrick.
With our next pick, we're going to take Pierre Sniper, unbelievable in the shootouts, playing for Vancouver this season, Radim Vrbata.
From the Vancouver Canucks, Radim Vrbata is making his NHL All-Star Game debut, leading his Canucks with 18 goals.
I can tell you this is a lot easier than one of the Sedins coming out from the Vancouver Canucks when there's a pick. Radim Vrbata, how about 12 years in the National Hockey League? He's played for six teams, and he's making his NHL debut at the All-Star Weekend.
An impressive season, 18 goals. He leads the team, 13 assists in 42 of the 45 games played for Vancouver this season. So Vrbata goes to Team Foligno. Team Taves, you have got to pick your defenseman.
Me and Mark recently had some incidents on the ice, but I'd like to put this behind us. Mark Giordano from the Calgary Flames.
The captain of the Calgary Flames, Mark Giordano, was named the NHL's first star in November after putting up four goals and 12 assists in 13 games. He currently sits at the top of the league in points by a defenseman this season with 40.
Mark, don't go anywhere. Not getting off that easy. You were undrafted in the NHL, but you go drafted here tonight. How do you feel about going to Team Taves? You heard what Getzlaff.
Oh, sorry.
Man down. Okay. Trying to knock me out up here.
Yeah.
You were right about him. He's a tough guy to play
against.
He
is, hey?
Yeah, we didn't have we played against him last game. We didn't have the we didn't agree with everything. Let's just say that. But thankful.
We got the same hairdo though.
Yeah, same haircut. But thankful that he was the first guy ever to draft me. So I'm really happy.
All right, we're gonna let go. I don't want to get my face knocked out again.
No,
but
we're mending some fences here between these two guys. And Dustin Byfuglien the other night in Winnipeg was taking some big runs at Nick Foligno. And Foligno still takes Dustin Byfuglien. So I like the way everybody's coming together. Team Foligno, you have to take a defenseman.
I'm going to say Oliver.
Am I up?
Yeah.
All right. With our next pick from the Arizona Coyotes, we pick Oliver Ekman-Larsson.
From the Arizona Coyotes, Oliver Ekman-Larsson is currently on pace to shatter his career high of 15 NHL goals set just last season. He also founded and now oversees his own line of luxury clothing, OEL.
He's got some fashion sense. You guys with your shoes and the skates? This guy has his own clothing line. Team Taves.
One defenseman left. You have to make a defensive choice. So I don't want to do all the work for you, Jonathan and Rick and Ryan, but who are you going to take here in the next round?
I mean, just give me a minute here. I will take Justin Falk.
From the Carolina Hurricanes, Justin Falk's two shorthanded goals this season rank first among all NHL defensemen. He leads Hurricane defensemen in goals and points, and he is first on the Canes in assists.
Justin Falk having a great season with the Carolina Hurricanes, participated at the Sochi Winter Games last year for Team USA. He is the final defenseman chosen for Team Taves, leads the Hurricane defenseman with 8 goals on the season, hoping to score more goals on Sunday and show off some skills tomorrow. In the skills competition, back to you guys, the Team Foligno. Lots of laughing voice. Going on over there. What's so funny?
Be honest.
Yeah? Okay, I'm going to try and pronounce his name. From the Buffalo Sabres, Zemgus Girgensson. All right.
From the Buffalo Sabres, Zemgus Girgensson receives the most fan votes for this year's NHL All-Star Game, topping 1.5 million. He's currently the only Latvian-born player on an NHL team roster.
Congratulations. NHL All-Star Game debut. What about the support that you got from Latvia, the highest vote getter in the 2015 fantasy draft balloting?
It was just crazy. People went a little bit over the board back home, but it was nice to see it.
When did you realize that this was going to become a real possibility? Were you tracking it at all?
You know, I thought it was a joke at the first when I saw the first week votes, but after that, I understood the Latvians were on a mission.
How did Nick do with the name?
Oh, he was good. I think his brother got a good word for him in there.
Zemgus Girgensson, a member of Team Foligno. Back to Team Taves.
That guy was a new guy. Yeah.
All right, with our pick, this guy seems to burn the Rangers every time, so hopefully we can use him on Sunday. Tyler Johnson.
From the Tampa Bay Lightning, now in his second full season with Tampa Bay, Tyler Johnson was a 2014 Calder Trophy finalist. He was also named to the 2014 NHL All-Rookie Team.
Third NHL season, making his first All-Star Game appearance. He leads the team in assists and points. 8 points alone since January 1st. He's played in 46 of the 48 games for the Tampa Bay Lightning, and it is Tyler Johnson going to Team Taves. There are 3 players left. Hi, Ovi, we see you. Lobbying for the car.
This is the difference between a car. a potential car.
I think
and
they're too nice to him. He asked for a free car, and he may get it. So, and Team Foligno, you're on the clock.
Who cares? What's he gonna do?
I will take Alex Ovechkin.
The captain of the Washington Capitals, Alex Ovechkin, leads the NHL this season in power play goals. He has won the Rocket Richard Trophy four times during his nine full NHL seasons.
Refusing to come out.
Maybe he's requesting a trade.
Two players left. Alexander Ovechkin, that close to new wheels.
Sorry, Ovi, buy a car.
No. just buy the car, Ovi.
The third last player taken is a four-time Rocket Richard Trophy winner. Some serious talent.
He almost had his case, but he needs his phone. All right, he needs his phone. He needs to call everybody and tell them that he's not going to get a car. There is a twist, though, everybody. And no, don't look at me. You're not getting the car. Maybe the other two back there
will. I got some bad news, too. They may have lost.
There is a big twist, though, however, this year. And we're going to tell you all about it. It's a big surprise coming up after the break. Which players, however, best fit the team for Team Foligno? Is it Forsberg or Nugent Hopkins? Those are the two players available. We'll find out which team they go to and what the big fancy twist is coming up after the break on the 2015 NHL All-Star Fantasy Draft presented by DraftKings.
Canada, backstage.
Free trial today at netsissue.ca.
Welcome back, everybody, to the 2015 Fantasy Draft presented by DraftKings, and here's Alex Ovechkin's night. It began with lobbying with signs to try and get himself a brand new 2015 Honda Accord. He's finally picked at the end, and he will not get his car. He will get a spot on Team Foligno, but one of these two men standing to my left will get a brand new flashy car. And before we get to them, how about a round of applause for the great city of Columbus? Welcoming all of us here for the All-Star Game, a great crowd. And you guys have all been very active on your phones all night long on NBCSports.com/vote. We want you to continue voting right now as it is very close right now to see who is going to go next. The Honda picks which player the best fit for Team Foligno, who is on the clock. It's swaying a little bit towards Ryan Nugent Hopkins right now. And it is a final. You, the fans, have chosen Ryan Nugent Hopkins to go to Team Foligno. Congratulations, Ryan. That means Philip Forsberg, you're going to Team Taves.
Did you have a preference either way?
No, either way. It's good to be part of the home team here.
What was it like sitting back there for all that time?
It was funny just listening to Ovi. I think he really wanted that car bad. A little disappointed right now.
Do you think he pushed it too far? Do you think that's what cost him?
Yeah, maybe. I think he was a little bit too much for it. He was pushing a little too hard.
Philip, first All-Star appearance. You get to play in the big game now. What's it been like this year for you? Breakthrough year in your rookie season.
Hold on. We have a little bit of a surprise. We're going to get that answer in just a second. Ryan, get back up here for one minute. We have a little bit of surprise in store.
Because normally the last pick.
You missed out on two.
The last pick is always awarded a car. But this year, it didn't really go down that way because the fans voted. So we didn't think it was fair that the last pick got a car. We thought we'd give you both a brand new Honda Accord.
And thanks to our friends at Honda for the 2015 Honda Accord. Look at that flashy car. You each are going home with one tonight. So, Philip, not so bad, huh?
No, I mean, 6-hour drive back to Nashville would be nice in a new car.
There you go. No. Are you taking your Nashville teammates with you in that brand new car?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, the coaching staff is here, so we have to squeeze in the back.
Any chance, Ryan, that you... that you'll dangle that in front of Ovi?
You can hear him already over there, yeah. Yeah, I might have to do that a little bit.
Part of Team Foligno, Ryan Nugent Hopkins and Philip Forsberg from Team Taves, and they walk away with brand new cars. The rosters have been determined for the 2015 National Hockey League All-Star Weekend. Nick Foligno with alternate captains Patrick Kane and Ryan Johansson, along with Anze Kopitar. Steven Stamkos is out there. Phil Kessel, part of the first trade in National Hockey League fantasy draft history.
And take a look at Team Taves. It is stacked as well. Corey Crawford, Roberto Luongo, and Yaroslav Halak, your three goaltenders. A defense core that features Weber, Seabrook, Ekblad, Suter, Giordano, and Justin Falk, and a handful of scoring potential in the forwards. Don't forget, tomorrow at 7 o'clock, it is the 2015 Honda NHL All-Star Skills Competition, where the greatest skills in the world will be on display. And on Sunday, it is the 2015 Honda NHL All-Star Game on NBCSN in the United States, CBC and TV Aw Sports in Canada. How about another big round of applause for the two teams, Team Foligno, Team Taves. And thank you all for joining us here at the 2015 NHL Fantasy Draft presented by DraftKings. We'll see you all on Saturday.